Hi, I'm Agent Schroder, and today I'm going to show you how to get the most out of your tablet during class and while you're studying. Here's what you'll need: a tablet, the network login info, a multiport HDMI adapter that connects to the USB-C port on my tablet, and a stylus, book cover, and a compatible keyboard. I'll be using the Samsung Galaxy TabS7 and the included S Pen, so the steps might be a little different depending on your device. All right, let's get into it. This Samsung Galaxy TabS7 has a 120Hz refresh rate. A higher refresh rate allows for smoother movement when you scroll up and down and side to side. This is really beneficial for long-term use as it's easier on the eyes. It also has an 11-inch screen, which is really helpful when it comes to multitasking or watching videos. Before we dive in, it's always a good idea to check for updates. Manufacturers like Samsung are always making improvements to their products, and keeping your tablet updated is the best way to ensure you're using the latest and greatest. Let me show you how to do that. First, swipe down from the top of the screen, and then tap the gear icon to go to settings. Swipe up to scroll, and tap Software Update. Tap Download and Install. We'll see if there are any updates available. Looks like my tablet's all caught up. However, if you have one or a few, just follow the steps to install them. Keep going until you see the message, "Your software is up to date." It's also important to update apps from the Samsung Galaxy Store. Let me show you how to do that. From the home screen, tap on the Galaxy Store app. Then tap on the menu, and then Updates. If updates are available, tap the button to update all of them. To update your Google Play Store apps from the home screen, tap on the Play Store app. Tap the account icon in the top right and tap My Apps and Games. The Play Store will check for any updates. If any are available, tap the button to update them, and your tablet and apps should now be all up to date. Now, on my Samsung, there are a few apps that I really think are especially useful for doing homework and studying. First, I'll show you Dex, Samsung's desktop experience platform. Dex lets you change your tablet's layout to look a little bit more like the traditional desktop or laptop. To launch Dex from the quick panel, swipe down from the top, and then swipe down again to expand the quick panel. Tap the Dex icon and you'll see it pop up. I'll talk more about accessories in a minute, but if you're using a book cover keyboard, you can also launch Dex from there. Just press and hold the function key and press the screenshot Dex key. With Dex launched, you can now see a more traditional desktop with icons for apps. There's an app launcher in the bottom left corner, and any notifications will appear in the bottom right. You can easily switch between apps and multitasking as they're open in resizable windows. If you want a little more workspace, you can also connect the S7 to a large screen, either wirelessly or using a multiport adapter like this, and an HDMI cable. I won't do that today, but it's really helpful if you need more screen real estate. Samsung devices have a really cool feature called One UI connectivity. Not only is it easy to share content across multiple devices, but the experience will feel the same. This is true for a phone and a tablet, and also for a PC and tablet. Check this out. I can easily use my tablet as a second monitor for my PC. Pretty cool. All right, back to the action. In addition to Dex, Samsung Notes is a great app that allows you to add notes directly into existing files and even PDFs with the S Pen, or create your own documents. Speaking of the S Pen, let me tell you more about it. First, the S Pen charges easily by magnetically attaching to the back of my tablet. It has a low 9 millimeters per second latency, which means that writing and drawing will feel smoother and more natural. Again, the S Pen was included with my tablet, but let me show you a few optional accessories that can really make a big difference. A book cover like this helps protect it from getting scratched. Mine conveniently attaches magnetically. It also has two different viewing angles, so it's easy to adjust depending on where you're sitting. If you want, you can also get a book cover keyboard like this one. It can protect your tablet, secure and charge your S Pen, and it attaches to the back with magnets. But it also has a keyboard and trackpad, so you can easily take notes and write documents. You can even detach the keyboard and use the back as a kickstand, like this. All right, now let's get back to note taking. To take notes for class using the on-screen keyboard, a book cover keyboard, or the S Pen, just open the Samsung Notes app. Then tap the red icon in the lower right corner to create a new note. To choose different page types, tap the menu in the top right, then tap Page Template. There, you can scroll through different page types like lined, grid, dot, and more. To save your notes as a PDF, Word, or PowerPoint file, first open the note that needs to be exported. Then, tap the share icon in the top right and tap your preferred file type. Oh, and check this out. You can easily convert written copy to digital text. This is really helpful, especially when it comes to searching for it later. Pretty cool, right? And just like that, you can write a report or an essay, save it as a document, and email it to your teacher, all on your tablet. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, give it a like. If you have questions, leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more tech tips from Best Buy. Thanks for watching.